This is the Cumberland Art Gallery. That I've unfortunately got to rush through because I'm almost out of time here. This is a large room. A large empty room. This room would be perfect for fencing practice. Shoot, any kind of martial art practice, man. We passed the Victoria and Albert Museum earlier. Passage of the room. What's this thing called? The landing room, third. The embarkation of William III. Okay, one more room, and then outside. Ooh, that I like. Andy Warhol. That's cool. Cabinet of pictures. Oh, that's a tiny doorway into nothing. Starting to get long. That's one ugly baby on the wall, man. Oh. I'm sorry, but that's an ugly baby. What were these rooms used for before they were an art gallery?
It was a suite of apartments called the Cumberland Suite. Hmm. And it's for the Duke of Cumberland, who was the son of George II. So if you go to the Jordan story, you read a bit about the family history and politics. And George II's first son, Frederick, was displaced in their favour by this son, who was the Duke of Cumberland. Hmm. So he had this whole new set of suite, a room designed for him by William Kent. So you've got the bedroom with the bed niche with the two with the four columns either side. This would be the withdrawing, the first one is the presence chamber. Hmm. But the gallery has been restored to the 18th century aesthetics of how it would have been as a state apartment.
Yeah.
But then utilised also as gallery space.
Cool. Thanks, man. This was the bedroom, right?
Yes.
I'd kill to have my bed in there. Not literally, but you know. This would be an awesome bedroom. What are the side rooms? That's a nice room. Mm-hmm. All right, now I made a system, so I'm gonna turn it off and put it back on the next one.